फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन बेटे इज कंप्लीट द फॉलोइंग. यू आर गिवन विद प्रोपेन 2-4 एंड यू हैव टू, देयर इज अ PCl 5 रिएजेंट फॉर यू. यू हैव टू टेल ए एंड बी. फॉर द बी रिएजेंट इज AgCl. द बी रिएजेंट इज AgCl. सो बेटे PCl5 हेल्प इन द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ हेलो एल्केन्स. तो हियर ए विल बी PCl5, PCl3, SOCl2, HCl. These all help in the formation of haloalkane. They help in the formation of haloalkane. And AgCN. This CN is ambidient nucleophile. This CN is ambidient nucleophile. When present with the Ag, it will attack from this nitrogen side, from the nitrogen side, and form
isocyanide.
You are muted. So, which isocyanide will be formed? This one. This Cl and isocyanide. Okay. So next section we are seeing with convert the following. Again, you have to complete it. You are given with chloroethane and you are given with the reagent AgNO2. Again, NO2 is also a ambidient nucleophile. Here it attacks from the NO itself and it will form nitroethane. Form nitroethane. Next is we take complete the following. We are provided with chloropropane and you have to react with silver salt of acetic acid. You have to react with silver salt of acetic acid. And you have to tell us what is the product A and B. What is the product A and B? Okay, but it is another nucleophilic substitution reaction, which this group acts as a nucleophile and attacks here, and this AgCl will be removed. So you will A the product A will be an ester. And the product B will be AgCl. The product B will be an AgCl. Okay. So next is the following product is written and you have to write. Next conversion complete the reaction is you have got with this and you have to write the product now. This is nothing but a Wood's reaction. I have done in class plus one also. 2 moles of ये react करते हैं और NaCl निकल जाता है. भी remember. 2 moles कैसे react करेंगे? The product will be CH3, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, CH3. And 2 moles of NaCl will be eliminated. Means यहाँ पे आप दूसरा मोल कनेक्ट करोगे, यही मोल यहां से कनेक्ट करने शुरू कर दिए. ओके, सो दिस इज नॉट नथिंग बट द फोर्थ डायरेक्शन. इफ यू रिमेंबर आर एक्स प्लस एन ए आर एक्स, आर एक्स प्लस एन ए आर एक्स इन द प्रेजेंट ऑफ ड्राई ईथर यू विल बी गेटिंग 2-chloropropane, so you will get 2-2-dimethylbutene. Now, complete this reaction also. You are giving with the cyclohexene, methyl cyclohexene. This is methyl and you have to treat with HI. You have to treat with HI cyclohexene. Hanji, what is the product you will be getting? HI will add a closer double bond. HI will add a closer to double bond while it will add. It will no doubt add according to Markovnikov rule. So what does Markovnikov rule state? Negative part of adding one species go towards that carbon atom which have lesser number of hydrogen. So this is a double bond, one bond, two bond, three bond, and this is fourth one. This is a carbon. This is a double bond, this is a carbon. This is having one bond, two bond, three bond, and one hydrogen must be here. So here there is no hydrogen, here there is one hydrogen. From this reagent, the negative part is iodine and the positive part is hydrogen. So what will be going to happen? This iodine will be getting attached to this carbon and hydrogen will be getting to this carbon. And not showing the hydrogen, it is your wish to show or not, but definitely showing the iodine here. You want to show, then you won't have to show both the hydrogen. So the product is 1-iodo-1-methylcyclohexane. Okay, so बेटे ये हो गए few of the conversions. अब हम थोड़े से conceptual question देखें इस chapter के and then थोड़े से distinguished test and then the revision of the chapter will be finished and we'll take with the nitrogen and its compound in the next year. So I am taking few of the conceptual question now. ठीक. Why can aryl halides not be prepared by reaction of phenol with HCl in presence of zinc chloride? Why is aryl halide? Aryl halide kya hote hain? Benzene ke upar halide. Theek hai, ye aapse puch rahe hain ki aap aisa product kyun nahi bana sakte फिनॉल के साथ. यू विल रिएक्ट विद द फिनॉल, ठीक, विद HCl. ऐसा प्रोडक्ट नहीं बन सकता. कैन यू टेल मी व्हाई? एनीवन? एनीवन बेटे? ये हमने ना, वी हैव डन सो मेनी टाइम्स, सो मेनी टाइम्स. चाहिए चाहिए यहाँ पे लोन पेयर है जी, लोन पेयर रेजोनेंस में पार्टिसिपेट कर लेगा. यहाँ पे आ जाएगा बेटी डबल बॉन्ड करैक्टर. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस डबल बॉन्ड करैक्टर, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस डबल बॉन्ड करैक्टर द OH इज नॉट रेडली लॉस्ट. एज इन दिस पर्टिकुलर काइंड ऑफ रिएक्शन व्हेन यू रिएक्ट अल्कोहल विद HCl, it is Lucas reagent, you have done already. The formation of carbocation is there. So to form a phenyl carbocation by losing OH is not so much easy. As OH is participate in the resonance and there will be a partial double bond character. So this double bond character due to resonance made the breaking of the bond difficult. Because of this breaking of the bond difficult, this reaction can't be possible. But any question regarding why chlorobenzene doesn't go any substitution reaction or phenol can't undergo this kind of substitution reaction, you have only one answer. Because of resonance, there is double bond character. Either it is phenol or it is chlorobenzene. So next is, why it is necessary to avoid even traces of moisture during the use of Grignard reagent? Why it is necessary to avoid even traces of moisture during the use of Grignard reagent? Grignard reagent, जब भी हम use करते हैं in any of the reaction, you have seen जो solvent लेते हैं बेटे, we used to take dry ether. We used to take dry ether while we are reacting with any of, like we have done reaction of aldehyde, we have done reaction of ketones, we have done reaction of carbon dioxide with RMGS. This is our Grignard reagent. And never ever we use solvent which is cooler in nature, which have water in that. Which have water in that, we will not use. Why? Why? Because in the presence of the water, it will form alkane. It will form alkane. Because of formation of this alkane, this is our byproduct, so main product will not be formed. So the reaction, whenever you will do any reaction with RMGX, that is very good reagent, never ever use, chahe koi metals ki reaction dekha karo organic mein, tab bhi hum dry ether lete hain, kyunki wo bhi kya karte hain, you have doing the junior classes in the presence of water, they will catch fire. The solvent used in this particular type of reaction, either it may be Na, either it may be RMGX, generally we take dry conditions. So next question is, how do polar solvent help in the first step of SN1 mechanism? What is the first step of SN1 mechanism? The first step of SN1 mechanism is the formation of carbocation. This is SN1 mechanism, in which we have to take tertiary halide, and this is our slow step, that is RDS step, that is rate determining step. In this particular step, the formation of carbocation is given. This particular step, the formation of carbocation is there. Now they are asking us why the protic solvent, means the solvent which is having polar in nature, why polar jo solvent hai, it will helpful in the first step. There is a formation of carbocation, and if you use a polar solvent, what does polar solvent do? It will stabilize this carbocation. It will form the bond with it. Theek? So they will solvate this carbocation. Hydrogen bonding kar lega, and it will solvate it, and thus it will get stabilized, and thus the formation of carbocation will be easier. Okay? So next is, aryl chlorides and bromide. Aryl chloride, this is aryl chloride, and this is aryl bromide. This is aryl bromide. Now what are they asking us? Aryl chlorides and bromide can be easily prepared by electrophilic substitution of arenes with chlorine and bromine in the presence of Lewis acid catalyst. Means agar humne aryl chloride ya bromide banana hai, to hum arene se, means benzene se hum easily bana lete hain. Humne pata hai agar hum chlorine ki, or we will add bromine into it in the presence of Lewis acid. in the presence of Lewis acid, we know we can prepare these products easily. Now, what they want to ask us? They want to ask us, why does preparation of aryl iodides require presence of oxidizing agent? Why the preparation of aryl iodide require the presence of an oxidizing agent? Hanji, can anyone? Dekho bete, if you want to form this is iodine and we are taking a Lewis acid and we are forming iodobenzene. The byproduct will be formed is HI. क्योंकि हमें पता है कि एक आयोडीन चली जाएगी यहाँ पे और यहाँ पे जो एच है इट विल बी अटैच विद दिस आयोडीन. ठीक, इट इज इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशन. नो दिस एच आई ये जो बाई प्रोडक्ट बना है इट इज अ रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट. इट इज अ रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट फॉर्म. It is a reducing agent form. ये क्या कर देगा? ये reverse कर देगा reaction को. It will provide hydrogen again. The reaction will get reversed. So we need an oxidizing agent in this reaction like HNO3. कि अगर HI बना भी तो ये इसके साथ react करे, इसको reduce ना करने दे. ये खुद ही iodine बना देगा, इसको कुछ नहीं करने देगा, ये खुद ही it will be a oxidizing agent in this reaction. Okay bete, so we need an oxidizing agent in this reaction because HI that is formed in this particular reaction acts as a reducing agent and it help the oxidizing agent help us to remove this HI. Okay, so the reaction which is reversible is not be there. No more conceptual question I am taking over. Why does haloalkane easily dissolve in the organic solvent? Haloalkane easily dissolve in the organic solvent. Anyone? Hurry up. As in the bete, if I am talking about this question can be asked reverse also, both the type I am saying. If they are asking haloalkane can dissolve in the non-polar means organic solvent, doesn't have much polarity as compared to water. So second type of question comes, why haloalkane are insoluble in water? As they have large R group we know, because of this they can't form hydrogen bonding with water. As they become non-polar because of this R group. So they dissolve in the organic solvent rather than they will dissolve in water as they are not capable of forming hydrogen bond and R group masks the polarity of the halogen group and it renders it non-polar. That is why it dissolves in organic solvent. So next question is from the stereochemistry type of, why is butane 1-ol is optically inactive but butane 2-ol is optically active? Why does butane 1-ol is optically active and butane 2-ol, sorry, inactive and butane 2-ol is optically active? So we'll tell this by drawing the structure. As optically active compounds are those which have chiral carbon. The carbon which have different functional group attached, different alkyl group attached. The four carbon alkyl group which are attached, the four groups which are attached are the different ones. Okay, so we have butane 1-all and butane 2-all. This is our butane 1-all and this is our butane 2-all. So let us try to the structure of the compound. So what is butane 1-all? Butane 1-all is this one, CH3, CH2, 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 OH. If I am taking this carbon here, see, it has two hydrogen, one OH and one this alkyl group. So two of the group are similar, that is hydrogen. Now this is butane 2-all, CH3, CH, OH, CH2, CH3. अब ये जो कार्बन इसके ओ एच लगा है, इसके पास वन ग्रुप ये रहा, सेकेंड ग्रुप ये रहा, थर्ड ग्रुप ये रहा और फोर्थ वन इज हाइड्रोजन. दिस इसके साथ ओ एच लगा है, यू कैन सी one is here, second is here and third and fourth are similar. For optical activity, the foremost important condition is better to have chiral carbon. What is chiral carbon? Chiral carbon is a carbon which have different number, different type of group attached to it. Either it may be hydrogen or alkyl group. This kind of, this is having four different group. One is hydrogen, one is methyl, one is ethyl, one is OH. That is why this is optical active and it can form its mirror image. These are known as enantiomers. Okay. Next we are doing, although chlorine is an electron withdrawing group, yet it is ortho para directing in electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. Why? Again, I'm repeating. Although chlorine is an electron withdrawing group, yet it is ortho para directing in electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. Why? See, bete, it has no doubt electron withdrawing effect because of minus I. This chlorine withdraw the effect from the benzene, electrons from the benzene, because of it has minus I effect. But because of this lone pair, if we want to form the resonating structure, this will be formed like this. Now this electron will be moving this side. Oh, this will move this side and we will get again Okay. So now in the resonating structure, you can see it is the negative charge where electrophile, see, electrophile is prone to attack at every position if it is present as such in the benzene condition. But depending on the group attached to the benzene, it can be ortho-para directing or a meta directing group. When it is ortho-para directing, see, like halogens are attached, as they consist of lone pairs, they have plus R directive influence, plus R effect, that is mesomeric or resonance, that is plus R. Now, because of this plus R effect, it will donate the lone pair, and you can see the negative charge come on ortho position and the para position, not at the meta position. This is our meta position. No negative charge come at meta position, but a negative charge come ortho and para position. Because of this negative charge, now the coming electrophile can attack on these two positions. So that is why they are ortho para directing, yet they have minus I effect. They are withdrawing electron from the benzene, and side by side they are giving the electron in the benzene at the ortho and para position because of plus R effect. Got the point? Okay. So next conceptual question. Suggest a possible reason for the following observation. The order of reactivity of haloalkane, the order of reactivity of haloalkane is Ri is much more reactive than RBr, and RBr is much more reactive than RCl and then RF. Ri is much more reactive than RBr than Cl. Anyone?
Ma'am, as the size increases, overlapping decreases, and hence strength decreases.
Ri is much more reactive than Cl and Br. Okay. So overlapping कम हो जाएगी. There is low bond dissociation enthalpy. Okay. So you know the answer very well. Next is, but rather, we have seen some other reaction. RBr is much more reactive. There is exception, but also in some cases, the RCl they are considering much more reactive than RBr. RCl is much more reactive than RBr. ये भी आपको पता होना चाहिए. Ri तो इन दोनों से reactive है. मगर RCl is much more reactive than RBr when there is polarity in the bond. If अगर इस तरह का order पूछा जाए तो there is a RCl ज्यादा reactive क्यों जाता है Br से, क्योंकि Cl में polarity आ जाती है. ये इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी के कारण इलेक्ट्रॉन खींच के लेके चला जाता है. ठीक, अगर दिस काइंड ऑफ ऑर्डर विल कम. Otherwise, the bond dissociation, if this kind of order will come, then you will tell R group जब बड़ा हो जाएगा तो carbocation का बनना easy हो जाएगा. यहाँ पे bond dissociation enthalpy और यहाँ पे आपका work करेगा principle of polarity, the difference in electronegativity. Okay? So these two type of questions can be there. Generally, this type of question is asked. Okay, so the last question I am taking, 2 minute remaining. Ethers have low boiling point. Why? Can anyone? Ether doesn't have hydrogen bonding. Ether, because of no hydrogen bonding, weak van der Waals forces of attraction, they have low boiling point. So this chapter उसके अलावा distinguished test आते हैं. Most of the distinguished test में आप AgNO3 test लिखते हो. We have already done that cyclohexanil या क्लोरोबेंजीन में distinguish करना हो तो Cl easily निकल जाएगा cyclohexanil की conditions में. और इन केस ऑफ हेलोरीन ये Cl जल्दी से नहीं निकलेगा. Why? Because in this case there is again resonance and because of that resonance the chlorine can't be removed easily and thus will not give the test in case of halogens. So we'll take over next chapter on Monday and please do come reading it so we can cover more questions. Rather than revision may you will read the chapter yourself also and I will make you remember the important point from where the questions are being asked and then we will cover the questions. Okay, so now meeting is going to be over.